Hi, my name is Kendra Welch. I'm with Clay Sand Straw, and right now we're working on doing a finished lime plaster on the outside of a straw bale building in Bastrop, Texas area. The house belongs to Carol and Charlie Jones. They lost the original structure in a forest fire about a year ago, and now we're building them a beautiful straw bale house to replace it. It incorporates a lot of trees that they lost in the forest fire are included in the house. We milled some pine, and we also use some oak as some live edge stuff. And then the walls are straw bale on edge between framing members. And so we're looking at doing the exterior final plaster today. And it's a beautiful color. This is the wet color. Lime dries quite a bit lighter because it's a very powerful whiting agent. So we put a lot of pigment in this, but it's still gonna get a lot whiter than this. It's dark now because we keep the lime plaster moist for about 2 to 3 weeks after we apply the lime plaster. All right, so I wanted to talk a little bit about lime and why we use lime as an exterior finish instead of cement stucco or earth plaster. We use lime because it is, some people say breathable, but that is actually a misnomer. It does not breathe because there is no air exchange. What there is it's vapor permeable, which means that the surface can get wet and then it can dry out again without trapping water at any point in the whole wall system. So what that also means is that humidity from the inside or outside could travel through the wall without being stopped at any point. Because where humidity stops and turns into condensation becomes mold issues. And so we don't want to create any vapor barriers at all in a straw bale wall system, or really any conventional house system, because mold in Texas is a big issue in building. And so having vapor permeable buildings is very critical for us. We like lime because it's durable to driving rain when applied and finished correctly. Lime is good for other reasons. It's traditionally used as a disinfectant also. So, for example, nothing would ever grow on the surface of this. We do not use cement plasters because they are vapor barriers and have been demonstrated to contribute to mold issues within buildings, conventional and in natural buildings. And we do not use earthen plasters because earthen plasters are durable until they get saturated. And if they get saturated by driving rain, then and it continues to rain, then it will wash the plaster away. So we will do earthen plasters as exterior plasters in very protected areas, in screen porches, for example. And we have some on the backside of the building that are screen porch earthen plasters. But out here, we have only 3 feet of overhang, and we have a very exposed building site. You can see for miles in every direction. And so the storms just come raging across here and just slam right into these walls. And so we wanted to get something good and strong on the outside of this building. Okay. So this is high calcium lime that we get locally here. And we add 4 gallons of dry powdered lime to 4 gallons of water, and it makes 4 gallons of putty. And we always keep it with a little water on top so it doesn't get any crispies. And so when I'm getting ready to measure the lime into the mix, I pour the water off and then I mix it so that the putty is consistent throughout the bottom and the top of the bucket. Don't mix it, you get thin putty on top and thick putty on top. So we were doing a mix based on this 3 gallon bucket. So I'm gonna do three gallons of lime putty, 9 gallons of limestone sand, and 3 gallons of masonry sand, which is essentially a ratio of 1 binder to 4 aggregate, which is what works well with us for lime. And then we add these pigments. And we're just using natural pigments. So this is a red oxide, a burnt umber oxide, and also a yellow oxide. That we're using right now, there is 3 yellow, 2 red, and 1 burnt umber. and that makes that terracotta color. And we get these pigments at the local pottery supply store, so they're about $20 a bag, and for the whole house it's going to be about $250 in pigment. And, you know, a little more when we do the lime wash. But so pigments are nice, but if you're expecting to do an integral color in lime, it's not gonna be very dark. It's gonna have to be a fairly light color, because you have to put so much money in pigments into lime to get it to be a deep color. And so we usually just do a lighter color as at this base in the integral, and then if the client wants to push the color a little bit more into the deep ranges, then we'll do a wash over the surface, because your pigment just goes so much further in a wash, in a lime wash, than in integral color stuff. It's just little plastic polymers, you know, and you throw these into the mixer, and it totally breaks up into where there's just little fine hairs throughout the entire mix, and it prevents cracks. Makes it so much stronger. Engineers love it.